Have you ever heard that our body has body intelligence that can prevent you from aging skin, reduce your chronic inflammation, and even prevent you from various diseases by, I think you know what I mean, autophagy. So, here is the 5 best ways to boost your autophagy. Hi everyone, welcome back to our healthy channel, Triple H, How to Be Happy and Healthy. With me, Dr. Hans, nutritionist and working on functional medicine. Now I'm gonna tell you about the 5 best ways to boost your autophagy. Maybe you often heard about this term about autophagy. It's kinda like unique and like a cool term in our body. And yes, it's cool. Why? Because autophagy actually is like cellular process where cells in our body can break down and recycle their own damaged protein. So auto like means self and phagy means eating. In simple way, we can say that it's like a self-eating that our body can do it by itself. Yeah, and what proteins that I mean, it's not the dietary protein like a chicken, beef, sausages, bacon, and add anything that you think on your mind. But protein that I mean is like the enzyme, hormonal, neurotransmitter, or even the smallest cell in your body. It's made by protein. So it has like many purposes, like the cellular maintenance, then adaptation to stress, especially chronic stress, and also the disease prevention that I mentioned earlier, the many diseases that happen right in our society. The biggest one is like a cardiovascular disease, then the second is like diabetes and autoimmune, and also cancer. So there are many types of cancer, and we can prevent it by this autophagy term. So what else the benefit if we have a good autophagy, or we can boost autophagy in our body daily? First thing, it can improve our insulin sensitivity and our glucose regulation. So there are many kind of metabolic syndrome that origin from decrease of insulin sensitivity, or another term is insulin resistance. So this is like the root cause of many kind of metabolic syndrome, just name it, like atherosclerosis, then also diabetes, chronic kidney disease, and like even neurodegenerative disease like Parkinson, Alzheimer, and etc. Like now Alzheimer is like classified as type 3 diabetes, which the origin is also the same, insulin resistance. So if we can improve our insulin sensitivity by doing autophagy, of course it can like boost your metabolic health like in certain point. Then the second benefit, it can reduce your inflammation, which is like all the diseases that like end with itis, like sinusitis, bursitis, arthritis, and etc. It shows that it has inflammation inside it before and after. Then it can prevent what I mentioned before, neurodegenerative disease like Alzheimer, Parkinson, because it can boost your nervous system in a good way. Then it can prevent cancer, many kind of cancer, because it can reduce oxidative stress, which cancer is caused by oxidative stress in the first place. Then it can prevent you from aging, which is now like many people trying so hard to like rejuvenate their skin, to boost their skin health, to glow their skin. Well, if you can do autophagy in your daily basis, you can promote your cellular rejuvenation on your skin. And it has many various benefits as well by having autophagy daily basis. Then now, let's talk to the point. So how to boost this autophagy in our body? Because like many people talk about autophagy, like many people like suggest you to do many things or even take supplementation. But now I'm gonna tell you about the natural ways to boost your autophagy. The first thing, I know, you guess it. Yes, fasting. But how long and what type of fasting? Because I think there are many types of fasting in this world. And I'll suggest you to do like the simplest one, which is the water fasting. This is not the dry fasting. If you can do it, I think it could be better, but I will not force my patient to do it, like especially when they don't used to get fasting every day, like or maybe like they never do fasting before. I think it's kind of hard. So I think the simplest way is doing the water fasting for more than or at least 18 hours. So based on study, 18 hours is like, you know, it's like the border in our body, which we can boost the term of autophagy. This is like the body intelligence that I mentioned at the first video, because after we through the 18 hours fasting, our body has that intelligence to boost this term. And what you eat, when you eat, it's also very, very important, because like many of my patients or many of my followers in my social media, they told me that, Dr. Hans, I did like a fasting like in 1 year, 2 years, but I still don't get the benefits like what you say. Well, because what you eat, when you eat, it's very, very important. It's I always tell them like fasting is, it's kind of you go in a war. You know, how could you go in a war without any weapon, or maybe without like any exercise training before to your soldiers? Like our body has our soldiers as well, like our antibodies, T cell, B cell, natural killer cell, lymphocyte, etc. It's our body soldiers, body warriors, and we need to train them in a certain way by doing fasting and also the weapon that what you eat. So I'm not talking about the calories, like the calories thermodynamic law and etc. that many people like the calorie balance, etc. I think it's another thing, but by eating like a very nutrient dense food, I think it can push your autophagy in many certain ways. So this is not like the calorie restriction, but calorie restriction does boost autophagy as well. We'll talk about it in a minute. But what I'm gonna tell you is about low carbs diet. It really can boost your autophagy while you are doing fasting. So it's not only sugar-free, but also low carbs diet. Carbohydrates in general, except fiber and vegetables. Then polyphenol rich food that I mentioned, the nutrient dense. What I mean is a polyphenol, like you can get from like many herbs, then like vegetables. I think it's like the easiest way to get the polyphenol. Then like organ meats and etc. But make sure that if you eat like animal based, I think it will be better if you get the organic or grass-fed or pasteurized egg, the example. Then, what is the second thing that can boost your autophagy aside fasting? It's exercise. And what kind of exercise? The HIIT, or high intensity interval training and endurance exercise, has been proven in many studies that it can boost your autophagy. After you exercise, what the next thing that you need to pay attention? That's the antioxidants, especially the phytonutrients that now has been studied many about these phytonutrients, like just name it, like a resveratrol, then like the polyphenol that I mentioned before, then like sulforaphane, glucosinolates, allicin, and etc. Because this phytonutrients really, really important, because it act as antioxidant to prevent many radical damage that you create after you get exercise. Okay, let's move to the number three. So what can boost your autophagy? It's a cold exposure. what kind of cold exposure? It's like it means like a very, very cold. Like if you ever heard about like the
cold bath,
it's one of the things that can boost your autophagy because your body create like a acute stress, high stress in a short period, and it could be better if you can like doing like switch, like a cold to heat exposure. I think it will be like a better rather than just like only cold exposure. The number four that can boost your autophagy is sleep. Yeah, it's like a no-brainer. It's like very simple, but not only like a general sleep, but you have to do like the quality sleep. So quality is much more important over quantity because many of my patients like sleep about like 6 to 8 hours, but they still feel like a lethargic when they wake up. So it means that you didn't have the good quality sleep that I mean. And affected by many kind of things, especially melatonin. So many people trying to like take melatonin as a supplement. I don't really recommend it because like a melatonin supplement is an artificial synthetic melatonin that it's not the natural melatonin that produced by your body. And if you're interested that I'm talking about melatonin, maybe we can talk like in the next video, not in this video, because I don't want to make it too long and just want to make it simple. And last but not least, as I mentioned in the first tips about fasting, caloric restriction does also boost autophagy. Why I don't really recommend it? Because this calorie restriction like often lead to malnutrition, which is like especially like many people that don't really understand about nutrition. They just like count the calories with like apps, my fitness pal, like a fat secret and etc. Like which is it can lead to the malnutrition if you don't really understand about like what is the nutrient dense food, polyphenol rich food, antioxidant food, and etc. But caloric restriction does can boost autophagy through certain ways, like it can inhibit mTOR, so mammalian target of rapamycin. Yeah, it sounds like a very unique, but actually just if your body has high mTOR activity, it can reduce the autophagy effect. That's a simple way. Then it can also activate AMPK, adenosine monophosphate activated protein kinase. Yeah, I know it's kind of long term, but trust me, just like when it's activated, it can really boost your autophagy. And it can increase your SIRT1 genes as well, which is like SIRT1 genes that it has been studied long now that these genes, these SIRT1 genes, by Professor David Sinclair. Let me quote your name because you are like the most famous one that can study about these genes now, because it can extend your lifespan or maybe even health span, right? So now you know all the 5 things that can boost your autophagy. Now what you need to know about what to avoid, because I think this is like more important, because if you just do good things and you still do like bad things, it can like annihilate the good things, right? So what you need to avoid, just give you the 5 simple things. Firstly is of course frequent eating. So if you are grazing all the day long by taking like 5 meals, 6 meals a day, eat like every 3 hours, well, it will like eliminate your autophagy in your body. The second thing is high carbs diet. High carbs diet, as I mentioned before. So it's not only sugar, but carbs in general. Starch, especially digestible starch. So if you eat like a sugar-free product, but it still has like a high carbs, you have to beware about it. The third thing, of course, poor sleep. Yes. And the fourth, this is I haven't mentioned before, it's a drugs. Yeah, drugs can like eliminate your autophagy or avoid your body to get like the proper autophagy, especially corticosteroid drug, because it act as immunosuppressant in our body. It will increase your cortisol. It will, because cortisol can lead to the high blood sugar, high insulin, and etc. Like I mentioned before. And the last but not least, the 5th things that can make you out of your autophagy is chronic stress. Yeah, if you're living with someone that toxic, you're living in a like a toxic environment, toxic people or anything. Yeah, it can make you like have chronic stress that can like stay away from autophagy in your body. Just practice it day by day, because I know that create habit is not easy. So just make it gradually, make it consistent, and I'll see you in the next video.